Then a couple of extra coils here. These things, they don't produce much juice, but just to test to see, let's see what we can get from them. Just one, I just want to see what phase the magnets and everything. And that didn't work. Let's see. And you can see the problem here. It's on the 20. If anyone knows why this thing doesn't read in the micro and milliamps range in 20, then please let me know. It's really frustrating. Almost as frustrating as having to take these damn plugs. I should have listened to the review about this thing and not bought it, but you know, it was cheap and I was in a hurry. So I got this whole peak meter, and you to go from amps to voltage, you have to take the cable out and switch it, opening up a window and then place this back in, and it's really a pain. I guess it's great. This meter is supposed to take 1,000 volts, so if I was working with 1,000 volts, then maybe I would appreciate those efforts and my safety, but right now it's just a pain in the. Well, anyway, let's see what this thing does now. If there's anything at all, maybe it's not even hooked up. Just set to the wrong range. Yeah, set it at 20 volts there, and then let's see. Okay, I'm just going to push this with my hand. One of the reasons I like this project is because it gives me a chance to work with the flywheel effect. This is something I've been interested in since I was a kid. Well, I was a kid. I always thought that the motorcycles we ride now would be like those manga motorcycles, and they would all have center flywheels in the middle of them like this that will produce electricity. So this is really, yeah. Now let's see. I'm just pushing this along, and yeah, with those extra couple of extra small coils there, again, you have to 6 volts very easily. Like I said, the current I can't read, but 6 volts is good enough for just a few coils that I've plucked out of old motors. 6 volts. Let's do that 6 more times, and